But when you think electric vehicles, you think Tesla.
And it's this man, Elon Musk, who made electric cars cool. Tesla's worth over $700 billion and is one of the largest e-car manufacturers in the world. But problems in its gigafactories around the globe are raising eyebrows. Water and labor are both big issues. We look to Germany, the US, and Mexico and ask, is the push to drive greener vehicles fueling various crises? We want to know, what's the true cost of Tesla? Tesla is known as a disruptor in the auto industry. Its gigafactories are massive compounds, like here in Grünheide, a sleepy village about an hour outside of Berlin. The facilities are designed to allow for faster and more streamlined production, as Tesla aims to produce their slick e-vehicles. But all this heavy manufacturing on one site means concentrated water consumption. The Tesla Gigafactories started in the US, where the company was founded, then China and auto manufacturing giant Germany, most recently Texas. Giga Berlin was a big step.
That was basically Tesla saying, we're not scared of you.
Dan Ives is a managing director at Wedbush Securities, an investment bank based in the US. I reached out to him because he's a big time Tesla watcher.
We're going for you, Mercedes, BMW, and others. And that's part of the Musk mantra, which is hard to argue with if you look at what's been accomplished the last decade.
While the joke in Berlin at the time was that Musk, a noted techno fan, just wanted an excuse to visit some of the city's most famous clubs, the location was excellent for Musk for many reasons. The factory was built at breakneck speed, especially for Germany, where bureaucracy, approvals, and permitting can move at a glacial pace. It opened its doors in 2022. Germany has a long history of auto manufacturing, so one resource it has in abundance is well-trained workers, on top of a location smack dab in the middle of the EU.
At the end of the day, it's the center of the auto industry, not just in Europe, you know, many could say globally. So Berlin made a ton of sense, as well as the logistics of making cars in China and shipping them to Europe was a logistical disaster. That's why Berlin has been so important in terms of that spider web logistically getting it throughout Europe, as well as from a cost perspective, going to be significantly less now.
But one resource that is not as abundant as one might think is water, which is apparently laughable to Elon Musk back in 2021 when he was confronted with the idea that his factory might contribute to water problems.
Was a very impressive.
This region has so much water. Look around you.
But the local water supplier says there's no more water for further development stages.
No, this is completely wrong. It's like water everywhere here. Does this seem like a desert to you?
Okay, danke schön.
Yeah, to some extent, I have to say I have some understanding for him because it's a sort of a bit strange.
This is Martin Pusch. His work looks at waterway ecosystems and management.
In the Berlin area, Berlin-Brandenburg area, we have 3,000 lakes. So if you arrive by airplane, you would see lakes everywhere. So we are rich in lakes, but we are poor in water resources. Yeah, so this seems to be contradictory.
So despite being known for lakes and rivers, canals and streams, groundwater levels in this part of Germany have been declining for years due to climate change. So even as the needs of the area are increasing, water levels are sinking. And now, on the edges of the most populated city in Germany, there's a massive gigafactory. And that concentrated production, it also means concentrated water consumption. Not to mention, this area in Grünheide is actually in a water protection zone. And there's another problem, the kind of soil that exists in this part of the country, which is really sandy and almost like a sieve. While it allows rainwater to quickly reach aquifers, the sandy soil also makes it easy for pollutants to drain down and contaminate drinking water.
In case such pollutants would enter the aquifer, it could be, let's say, spoiled and make unusable for drinking water purposes, especially as most pollutants cannot be biologically or microbially degraded.
Since the completion of the factory, there's been intense scrutiny. German magazine Stern reported about a battery accident starting a fire and contaminated water seeping into the ground. Or in 2023, the magazine also reported about an illegal filling station that leaked 250 liters of diesel, quote, uncontrollably. These are just a few of the reported instances. Authorities also seem slow to criticize the company. In only 4 of these cases involving many different chemicals have state environmental authorities ordered soil samples to be taken. But is this simply a culture clash between an American company and German bureaucracy?
So the classical American approach, so I'm a settler, I'm going westward, I'm using an area, and then if I've been using it, then I move forward further. So this is obviously not possible in Central Europe, so we are limited in space. Yeah, you have to deal more carefully with the space and outdoor resources, and that's why we have these relatively strict environmental regulations.
It would only be fair to mention that the first company to build a factory in a water protection area in Germany was Mercedes-Benz, about a half an hour away from the Tesla site. But it's not just a US versus Germany issue. Around the world, Tesla has a rocky history with environmental regulations. The LA Times reported about fines for a California facility amounting to $275,000 from the Federal Environmental Protection Agency. It's not only environmental issues that the various Tesla factories have in common, but also building in areas with water problems.
California, which is worldwide known for the problems, Texas, the same, and also in China, near Shanghai. Even there is, let's say, enough water volume, the quality is so bad that you are not able to drink the official drinking water there.
But let's look on the other side of the U.S. border. Tesla is currently planning to build another gigafactory here in the state of Nuevo León, Mexico. That plant could open in the coming years, but one big problem? In February 2022, the state where that facility would be located declared a state of emergency due to the drought there, with 2 of the 3 dams that supply the metropolis of Monterey recording historically low levels. But as of now, Tesla says it's still moving forward with the facility in Nuevo León.
Mexico is important because of the low cost nature. To produce what I believe will be a sub-$30,000 vehicle, Mexico is really the only choice. And that's why logistically where it is relative to Austin makes a ton of sense.
This area outside of Monterey, like the area outside of Berlin, has an existing automotive sector with companies that supply American manufacturers like this one. The company Kia is already operating in the state, for example, so Tesla could also be looking to court talent and take advantage of the infrastructure already in place.
80% of the exports of the auto industry goes to the United States, and it's around $15 billion per year of production and exports of auto parts and some production of vehicles.
Manuel Montoya heads the automotive cluster of Nuevo León.
And in comparison with Mexico, Nuevo León is one of the main states that produces cars and auto parts.
Montoya says water concerns are, quote, challenging for existing companies, but points to new plans on the horizon and already in the works. The governor of Nuevo León unveiled a $1.25 billion investment plan designed to ensure the state's water supply through 2050, to invest in water infrastructure like new pipelines and a new dam.
There's more water coming to the city, and the state government of Nuevo León, they have already a plan for the next 20 years to supply the water that not only the companies, but also the population will need for the next 20 years.
But nearly 5 million people live in metro area Monterrey. There has already been water supply rationing in recent years, with media reporting that some water truck delivery drivers have even been threatened with kidnapping. In a time where climate change is adding even more stress here in Germany, Tesla's environmental record is raising concerns among activists.
Environmental has always been a push-pull for Tesla that they need to navigate. Clearly, the green nature in terms of going to electric vehicles, a lot brighter spotlight. But it's a work in progress.
So how do these recent and planned buildups fit into the global Tesla strategy? The planned facility in Mexico and the Gigafactory buildup in Germany will help Tesla compete on costs, even as traditional car makers turn to EVs, and while Chinese companies like BYD start to ramp up outside of China. But let's look at global sales. Tesla may have brand recognition, especially in the West, but China is gaining, with BYD making massive strides in 2022. Their sales more than tripled compared to 2021, with German carmaker VW lagging behind in third place.
BYD, they continue to compete with from maybe a global share perspective. But when you think electric vehicles, you think Tesla. And that's been a big part of their success. Right now, it's still Tesla's world. Everyone else is paying rent relative to globally. And now it's just doubling down on that. That's why Germany, what they've done in Giga Berlin is so important.
So not only are Germans and Americans making Teslas, they're buying them too. Over 500,000 were bought in the U.S. last year, but another big buyer is Sweden. So in these countries where Teslas or parts for the cars are made or serviced, there's unrest. Like in Sweden, where workers are protesting. Swedish Tesla mechanics have walked off the job. Though their number is small, the movement has sparked solidarity efforts across not only Sweden, but also Denmark. Dock workers are refusing to unload Teslas, and for weeks the postal service refused Tesla deliveries. The Swedish mechanics want the company to sign a collective bargaining agreement, which would let them negotiate for higher wages, pensions, and the like. Workers' rights are an issue in Germany, too. German media has reported numerous concerns among Giga Berlin employees about working conditions.
From the USA, especially from the CEO, probably comes a lot of pressure to deliver numbers, to produce cars and to sell those cars. And yeah, in the end, to provide better numbers for the shareholders, right? So that the stock goes up and he can buy another Twitter or whatever he wants to.
Gunnar Heymann is a member of the IG Metall union in Germany and was employed by Tesla. Musk's company has so far blocked unionization at its factories, but a works council is in place at Gigafactory Berlin.
The non-union nature has been part of the success of Tesla. I mean, they're not, I wouldn't say, have the overhang that some of these other automakers have by having unions. And that's really how Musk built it. And I don't see that changing anytime soon, despite UAW and others that will go after him. But they go to the beat of the different drum, and that's been a big part of their success, being non-union.
We wanted to know, what do the people who live in and near Grünheide think about the factory and the working conditions?
If you get a lot of people in really quickly, it's going to be a lot of stress for everybody involved. It is difficult, I mean, but I still think that it's like teething problems that will be solved in the future.
Ja, ich habe gemerkt, dass da jeden Tag Krankenwagen vorfahren, dass sehr oft Verletzte sind.
Wir kennen jeden einen, der hat bei Tesla gearbeitet, der hat aber sofort wieder aufgehört, weil es hat nichts geklappt. Ich glaube, er hat noch nicht mal Arbeitsbekleidung bekommen.
Tesla made a worldwide profit of around $12.5 billion in 2022. But what is the true cost of buying one of these futuristic, cool, all-electric vehicles? Well, hosting a Gigafactory brings jobs, but also working conditions that can lead to injuries, like here in Germany. And a factory with such a large footprint can also strain local resources and make regions experiencing drought face even greater limitations. We did reach out to Tesla for interviews and for comment. They did not respond to those requests. Tesla has been an innovator for years, so there's still room to improve. And water usage or working conditions could actually be another frontier that this American company confidently strides into.